All those who have been going by local trains from VT or Masjid, etc., you must have found in the roadside export surplus mal, purchase it, selling at a concession rate, etc., etc., etc. Right? Under the legal metrological order, it is not allowed to be sold. An export package shall not be sold in India unless the manufacturer or package has repacked or relabeled the commodity in accordance with the provisions, and where any export package is sold in India without such repacking or relabeling, such package shall be liable to be seized in accordance with the provisions of this Act. So today, you cannot buy all those items. Okay, buy it quietly and go away quietly. These are all different issues. Even today, it is being sold on the road. Nobody checks it, or somebody checks it and then finish. But as far as your examination is concerned, don't say this, huh? Your examination, you will mention, no, it is not required to be sold in India under any condition, unless it is repacked and relabeled. Another of the most important rules is IPR, or Intellectual Property Rights, that is Imported Goods Enforcement Rules. Now, intellectual property rights has been held to be in very high esteem as far as the world is concerned, especially America, Europe, etc. They consider intellectual property to be of a very high order, because most of their earnings are in the form of royalty arising out of the intellectual property. And by means of the IPR, we do not have a separate act, but we have got an enforcement rules. Goods infringing intellectual property right means any goods which are made, reproduced, put into circulation, or otherwise used in breach of the intellectual property laws in India or outside India, and without the consent of the right holder or a person duly authorized to do so by the right holder. So, we come to the intellectual property. What does intellectual property mean? It means a copyright as defined in the Copyright Act, trademark as defined in the Trademark Act, patent as defined in the Patent Act, designs as defined in the Designs Act, and geographical indication as defined in the Geographical Indication of Goods Registration and Protection Act. Therefore, these five or six acts have been clubbed together under IPR enforcement rules. What does intellectual property law mean? Copyright Act 1957, Trademark Act 1999, Patents Act 1970, Designs Act 2000, or the Geographical Indication of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999. These acts are said to be intellectual property law. Who is a right holder? It means a natural person or legal entity which, according to the laws in force, is to be regarded as the owner of protected intellectual property right, its successor entitled or is duly authorized exclusive license, as well as an individual, a corporation, or as an association authorized by any of the aforesaid persons to protect its rights. A right holder. Now, what is the procedure involved? Here, first of all, a right holder, that means a person holding and IPR for various any item by means of trademark or design, etc., etc. He becomes a right holder, may give notice in writing to the Commissioner of Customs or any proper customs officer authorized in this behalf by the Commissioner at the port of import of goods infringing intellectual property rights in accordance with the procedures. And within 30 working days from the date of receipt of the notice, the Commissioner shall notify the applicant whether the notice has been registered or rejected and notify the conditions for registration. It means both ways, that if certain protected item is being imported into India and the right holder has got a representative in India and he objects to it, no, that particular importer cannot import these goods, should be imported only through us. So he will make an application to the customs. After the grant of the registration of the notice by the Commissioner on due examination, that means the goods would be examined by means of various documents, the import of alleged infringing goods into India shall be deemed as prohibited. That means the goods could be treated as prohibited. Otherwise, under our Indian list of items to be imported, it is allowed. But by virtue of IPR, it would deem to be prohibited within the meaning of Section 11 of the Customs Act. They would be treated as prohibited goods. What happens to prohibited goods? Suspension of clearance of imported goods, examination of goods by right holder, supply of information to the right holder, and supply of information to the importer. This is the normal procedure within the customs department. The goods which have infringed the intellectual property rights are first detained or seized and subsequently confiscated under Section 111D of the Customs Act. We come to one of the most important, and I don't know whether I should go ahead with this or not. Iske bina hamara kaam kahan se hota hai? Prevention of Corruption Act. Hum jab tak pocket mein haath nahi dalega, hamara kaam nahi hoega. So how can we go about with this? What is corruption? Let us understand that. And then we will know that all of us are corrupt. Include not the customs officers, but all of us are corrupt. Public servant taking gratification, including valuable gift. Aap rado go ghadi pehen ke custom house mein gaya, custom officer bolta aapka ghadi bahut achha hai, humko de dijiye as gift. You give it to as gift to him. It's a part of corruption. Others taking gratification to influence public servant. What do we tell our clients? हाँ, वो कस्टम ऑफिसर हमारा दोस्त है, हम ले दे के उसको पटा देगा, आपका काम कर देंगे हम, लेकिन इतना खर्चा होगा. तो we take from the importer, we come under this clause. Others taking gratification to influence public servant. कस्टम ऑफिसर हमारा दोस्त है, उनको इन्फ्लुएंस करेगा ना. सो वी गेट डायरेक्टली कम इन टू दिस एक्ट. Others taking gratification for exercise of personal influence with public servant. What are the offenses? There are three or four very small offenses over here. Section 7 says public servant taking gratification other than legal remuneration in respect of an official act. First of all, public servant. We are not public servant, are we? No. We are half custom officer, but not public servants. Right? Because we don't take directly for doing that work. So it's public servant who who is taking gratification other than legal remuneration. Legal remuneration is his salary and other benefits that he gets from the government.